Hello children, welcome to Learning Made Easy. Today we're gonna learn a non-detailed lesson from the book An Alien Hand, the NCERT book prescribed for grade 7. And we're gonna learn the lesson Bringing Up Kari, written by Dhangopal Mukherjee. Before learning the lesson, let's have a glimpse about the author children. Dhangopal Mukherjee was an Indian writer who was born on 6 July 1890 in Calcutta. He died on 14 July 1936. Dhangopal was educated in the USA and he wrote many books. Some of his famous books are Hindu Fables for Little Children, Visit India with Me, Disillusioned India, Rama the Hero of India, Kari the Elephant. And today we have the lesson Bringing Up Kari, and this is a piece extracted from the book called Kari the Elephant. Let's start with the lesson, children. The lesson is narrated by Dhangopal Mukherjee himself. And as the lesson begins, Dhangopal Mukherjee was 9 years old in this story. Look at the sentence given here. This line is told by Dhangopal Mukherjee. I was 9 years old and I could reach his bag. His refers to Kari. When Dhangopal Mukherjee was 9 years old, he receives an elephant as a gift, and this elephant was named as Kari, and Kari was just 5 months old at that time. Kari, when he was just a 5 months year old elephant, at that time itself, he was tall enough and Gopal had to stand on his tiptoe, at the tip of his toe, to reach Kari's height. Kari was kept in a tent, a kind of tent called as pavilion. Children, whenever you look at a hard term with a meaning, kindly take it down in your rough notebook or in your book. Kari lived in a pavilion, as I told you earlier. A pavilion is a tent made of thatched roof. When I say thatch, it means a roof covered with straw, palm leaves, or any other dried plant parts. Like the concrete ceiling we have in our houses, the tent was made of thatched roof. And the thatched roof would be kept resting on very thick stumps. The word stumps means sticks, because every now and then Kari would bump against the poles. The word bump means hit and poles means sticks. If Kari is going to damage the sticks or poles, the whole tent would collapse. So to avoid this, the tent would be kept resting on very thick stumps. Children, in this story, we're going to see how Kari saves a boy and how Kari is very naughty, and at last we're going to see how Kari learns many lessons from Gopal. Kari usually doesn't eat much, but he needs nearly 40 pounds. 40 pounds means 18 kg of twigs to chew and play. Just for playing itself, he needs 40 pounds. So every day, the narrator takes Kari to the river to take bath. After reaching the river, Kari would lie on the sand bank. Underline the term bank. The word bank means a land or the piece of land alongside a river or a lake. Look at the picture, children. A land that is nearby a lake or river. Kari would lie on the sand bank. At that time, Gopal would take some fresh sand and he would rub Kari with the sand to clean Kari. After that, Kari would be playing and resting in the water. After that, when Kari emerges out of the water, Kari's skin would shine like ebony. Ebony is a type of tree. And here, ebony refers to the dark and smooth skin of Kari, which looks just like the wood taken from the ebony tree, dark and smooth. After this, the narrator Gopal would take Kari by his ears and he would leave Kari at the edge of the jungle so that he can go and collect some leaves for Kari to eat. Gopal would collect luscious twigs for Kari. Underline the term luscious, juicy, tasty and juicy. And Gopal would carry a hatchet. Underline the term hatchet. Hatchet is a very small kind of axe with short handle. And Gopal would be very careful while cutting the twigs because Kari would not eat damaged twigs. Underline the term mutilated, it means damaged twigs. I told you right, Kari is a baby elephant and damaged twigs would cause damage to his mouth. So he would not eat mutilated twigs, damaged twigs. And it is not very easy for Gopal to collect leaves or twigs for Kari because Kari has to eat tender plants, right? So Gopal would climb all sort of trees to collect tender twigs or saplings for Kari to eat. Underline saplings, baby plants. Gopal would collect saplings also for Kari. Mostly he would collect young branches of banyan trees because Kari loved to eat those young branches of banyan trees, and the banyan trees would look like a cathedral of leaves. Underline the term cathedral, a church building. So the banyan trees would look like a church building completely made of leaves. These are all the daily routine works of Kari and Gopal. One day in March, it was a spring day. On that day, Kari was taken by the narrator to the river. After taking bath, Kari was left at the edge of the river and the narrator had gone inside the jungle. After some time, the narrator could hear Kari crying like a baby. Immediately, the narrator Gopal runs to rescue Kari. When Gopal reaches the river, he could not see Kari anywhere. Gopal was agitated. He was very sad. At that time, Gopal could see only Kari's trunk out of the water. Slowly, Kari's trunk emerges out of the water. And Gopal cannot jump inside the water to save Kari because by now, Kari is very huge. Kari weighed nearly 400 pounds. That means 182 kg. And Kari keeps trumpeting. Underline the term trumpets, makes loud noise. Kari makes loud noise and he moves with difficulty towards the river bank. Being a small boy, Gopal is unable to help Kari, the huge elephant, because by now Kari is much grown up. Kari pulls Gopal inside the water and Gopal was confused by the action of Kari. Instead of coming out, Kari is pulling Gopal inside the water. After reaching the water only, Gopal finds that a small boy is in danger. He lies floating at the bottom of the river. But Gopal is not a good swimmer. He doesn't know swimming properly. So the current, underline the term current, it means flowing water. The current pulls him away. But Gopal somehow tries to hold the boy and they both, Gopal and the boy in danger, they both drift in the water. Underline the term drift, taken by the flowing water. Here the meaning is taken by the flowing water. Now who's gonna save Gopal and the boy? Let's see. Usually, Kari would be very slow and ponderous. Underline the term ponderous, inactive. Kari would be very sluggish. But today, Kari acted like a hawk. Hawk is a hunting bird and it acts and moves very quickly, very swiftly. So Kari acted like a hawk today to save Gopal and the boy. By this time, Gopal had reached the bottom of the river and he touched the ground. So he had to double his legs. So he had to Bendeslig. Underline the term doubled, bent. By this time, Gopal has reached the ground, right? Gopal finds something holding his neck. Something like a lasso. Underline the term lasso, rope. Gopal was very much scared because he thought that some water animal is going to kill him. He thought that the trunk of Kauri might have been a snake or some other water animal. Later, he understood that it was only Kauri's trunk and Kauri was trying to rescue Gopal and the boy. Somehow, Kauri pulled both the boys to the ground and they both were saved by Kauri. Gopal tells us that saving this unknown boy was one of the greatest achievements of Kauri. Children, sometimes animals behave smarter and kinder than human beings. Naughty Kauri. Kauri was very naughty like a baby. And he started doing so many naughty things when he started eating bananas. Usually, Kauri would eat only twigs and leaves, right? But someone introduces bananas to Kauri. From that day onwards, Kauri starts eating bananas and he is fond of ripe bananas. He loves ripe bananas very much. Usually, Gopal's parents would keep large plates full of fruits on the dining table. One day, a plate full of bananas disappeared. After this incident, Gopal found some smashed bananas in Kauri's pavilion, in Kauri's tent. Gopal was literally surprised because he thought that Kauri would eat only twigs and leaves. But the next day, something happened. What was that? Gopal was seated at the dining table and he was thinking whether to eat the fruits without his parents' permission. At that time, Gopal notices that something like a very thick black snake entered through the window. Actually, it was Kauri's trunk, but Gopal didn't know it. Actually, Gopal was scared that it was a snake and he ran out of the house and he wanted Kauri's help because he saw Kauri at that time moving towards Kauri's tent. Gopal was running towards Kauri and then Kauri was caught red-handed. Kauri was eating the bananas. Gopal was still. Gopal was standing like a statue. He was still in astonishment. Underline the term astonishment. It means surprise or shock. Why Gopal is shocked? Let's see. Whenever the bananas were stolen by Kauri, Gopal's parents thought that Gopal was stealing the bananas and eating them without getting permission from them. They were all angry at Gopal. But today, Gopal found that Kauri was the thief and immediately Gopal shows this to his parents and Gopal also holds Kauri's ears and he scolds. He rebukes Kauri for stealing. From that day, Kauri started behaving. Kauri stopped stealing forever and he has also learned a good manner. He thanks whoever gives him food. Thanking someone for their help is a good manner, right? But how Kauri would thank? He would make a very low noise and the same noise would be repeated by him whenever someone gives him food. And the noise means thank you. Children, the narrator says that if a punishment is given to elephants and if it is for a right reason, the elephants would accept it. But if you're gonna harm an elephant without any reason, they would pay you back. Underline the term pay you back, it means take revenge. Even animals take revenge like human beings. The narrator wants Kauri to learn. Like children going to school, Kauri should also be taught so many things. First of all, Kauri should be taught to understand the signal to walk forward. To understand the signal to walk forward, It took just 3 classes for Kari to learn the word Mali, which means walk forward, and Gopal would hold Kari's trunk and he would pull and say Mali. Immediately, Kari would understand that he would walk. But the next thing was teaching Kari to sit. It was very difficult for Gopal to teach this, and it takes nearly 3 weeks for Gopal to teach this. Gopal would pull Kari's ears and he would say the word that, and Kari should sit. But to learn this lesson, it took nearly 3 weeks for Kari. And why Kari should sit? Because by now, Kari is very much big. He is 3 years old, but he is taller than Gopal, and Gopal is unable to climb over him without a ladder. Gopal needs a ladder to climb over Kari. So Kari must learn to sit down so that Gopal can climb over Kari easily. The next difficult lesson was teaching Kari to make the master call. And Gopal tells that this is the most difficult lesson because the master call is something tricky. Gopal explains what a master call is. Master call is made by creating a hissing sound like a snake, followed by a howling sound like a tiger, as if a snake and a tiger are fighting. And this sound should be made by Gopal. Gopal would make this sound in the ears of Kari. Immediately, Kari should understand that it is a condition of emergency. But Kari takes nearly 5 years to learn this lesson. And once he learns the lesson, it will be very useful. Gopal explains how this master call would be very much useful during emergency. He wants us to imagine if the narrator is stuck with the elephant in a jungle at night, and if he wants to escape from the jungle in the darkness, Kari would help him easily. Kari would pull all the trees out of the way. As soon as Kari pulls the first tree itself, the monkeys would wake up and they would jump from one tree to another, signaling. After seeing this, the stags in the forest would run here and there. Stags are a type of deer. They would look red and they would be seen mostly in mountain regions. So, every animal would move out of the way thinking that there is a danger. Even tigers would be frightened by the noise of pulling a tree. They would growl. Underline the term growl, it means make noise like roar. Even tigers would be frightened like the monkeys and stags, and they would growl. One by one, Kari would pull out all the trees in front of him and he would make a road immediately. This is actually a great skill learned by elephants. If elephants want a way to move around, they would just like that pull out trees in front of them. Likewise, Kari would also pull out all the trees in front of him and he would make a clear road towards Gopal's house. That's why Kari was taught the master call. Gopal taught Kari the master call to understand the situations of emergency. We have come to the end of the lesson, children. Now, what's the takeaway? What's the moral that we're going to learn from this lesson? We learned that even animals have emotions like human beings. Sometimes animals are better than human beings in being loyal, helpful, and in being kind. So children, we must learn to treat them properly. We should love animals and we should take care of them. Children, I hope you remember the Kerala incident. Such things would never happen if we love and take care of animals properly. With this, we have come to the end of the video, children. Hope you all enjoyed and loved the lesson, children. Let's meet in the next video. Thank you.